So hi everyone. Our project topic is on training of deep spiking neural networks via hybrid conversion. Myself Gaurav and I have Akshay and Mohammed with me on this project. So the basic overview of this project is to present a computationally efficient training technique for deep SNNs. We first train an ANN model with ReLU neurons using gradient descent, and we employ two approaches. The first one being ANN to SNN conversion via threshold balancing. So this technique estimates the firing threshold of each of the layers, and the details of this technique will be explained later by my colleagues. The second technique employs the first technique, and on the top of that, it performs spike timing dependent backpropagation, which uses a novel surrogate gradient function using neuron spike time. I'll request Akshay to move on from here.
Hi everyone, I'm Akshay. Let me go over the motivation for our project. Basically, spiking neural networks offer a low power alternative to conventional artificial neural networks, making them attractive for use in neuromorphic hardware implementations. With all their appeal for power efficiency, training SNNs still remain a challenge for us. There have been several works that propose ANN to SNN conversion, but such types of converted SNNs require large number of time steps to achieve computative accuracies, leading to higher energy consumption. Let me go over to the spiking neural networks in general. Spiking neural networks mimic a human neuron, and they use biologically realistic models of neurons to carry out computation. SNNs basically operate using spikes, where the occurrence of a spike represents the membrane potential of the neuron. And once a neuron reaches a certain potential, which is called the threshold potential, it spikes and the potential of the neuron is reset. The most common model employed for this is the leaky integrate and fire model. Let me go over the spiking neuron model. The equations shown here represent the spiking neural model. The pre-spikes obtained from the previous layer here are integrated as the current influx in the membrane potential that decays exponentially. The membrane potential integrates the incoming spikes through the weights and leaks with time constant tau whenever it does not receive a spike. When the membrane potential crosses the firing threshold, the neuron generates an output spike and the membrane potential is reduced to the reset potential. Let me go over the ANN to SNN conversion, which is the main contribution to our project. We propose a ANN to SNN conversion algorithm wherein we use the ANN SNN conversion as an initialization technique for spiking time dependent backpropagation. The goal here is to match the input and output mapping function of the trained ANN to that of an SNN. After obtaining the trained ANN, we first copy the weights from the ANN to the SNN and initialize the threshold voltages for all the layers to zero. The threshold voltages in SNN are estimated based on the ANN weights. The first step here is to generate a Poisson spike train corresponding to the entire training dataset. The process of generating spike train and setting threshold value is repeated for all the layers of the network. We employ two approaches for setting the final voltage. Mainly the baseline conversion approach and the scaled conversion approach. In the baseline conversion approach, we set the maximum activation for each layer to the threshold voltage. This is done for ANN and SNN conversion, which involves large time steps. In the scaled conversion approach, we scale the value of the threshold voltage at each layer by K, where K is a value between 0.2 and 0.4 for VGG architectures. Ask Mohammed to go over the SNN training.
Hi everyone, my name is Mohammed, and I will explain the SSN training based upon spike time based backpropagation. And this is described in algorithm 3. So the algorithm 3 takes a mini batch of input and our target pairs and the network model that and the initial weights and threshold voltages that were calculated before. And with that input, we will initialize the parameters, the membrane potential and the dropout mask and the spike timing. So, and now the algorithm has two parts. The first part is forward propagation. The second part is backward propagation. In forward propagation, we just take the input and using the equations that were described by my friend Akshay, and we will calculate the output. So you can see that in output layer, So there was no spiking, and after that word in the back propagation, it's the same learning rule that we just described. So, and the nextly, I will explain the architecture that we used. We used the Linet 5 architecture and VGG 16 architecture, which are described here. And the only the constraint that we used are two very important constraints. And first constraint is that no batch normalization was used. And the instead of average max pooling, we used average pooling. So these are the two main constraints. And now the dataset that we use is MNIST dataset and C410 dataset. Now I will request Gaurav to explain the results of the simulations. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Mohammed. Yeah. So this slide shows the results that we got in terms of the test accuracy for all the VGG and Linet architectures that we have used. So as you can see, the baseline accuracy have been reported in the second column, and the third column reports the test accuracies for the ANN to SNN conversion for a large number of time steps, like 2500. And the next column shows that how the accuracy gets degraded when we reduce the number of time steps. As you can see, that for t equal to 100 time steps, the degradation is very high, but for a large number of time steps, like 200 onwards, the degradation is minimal. And we also want to conclude one thing from the fifth column, that the hybrid training yields a very high training overhead. For example, training one epoch in SNN takes around 80 minutes with four V100 GPUs, while training one epoch in ANN requires less than one minute. So you can see there's two orders of magnitude difference. And the huge training effort is not compensated by the considerable gain in accuracy that we get. For example, for VGG16 architecture, t equal to 100 versus t equal to 200, we get less than 1% accuracy difference. And one more thing that we should note here is that we had explored the search space for the optimal scaling factor, and we have found that 0.7 to 0.9 suits the best for VGG architectures. And due to the high SNN training time, you could perform the STDB training for only 5 epochs. So I request Akshay to move on. Yeah. So these are the two convergence plots for VGG9 and VGG16 architectures. As you can see, that the baseline conversion and the scaled conversion are kind of similar, as we have large number of time steps. By large, I mean more than 500, and conversion plus STDB still gives the best performance, but marginally better than the other two. Akshay, can you move on? Yeah. And this also shows that the difference between the three training techniques is less than 0.5%, even if time steps is as low as 300. Akshay, can I move on? Yeah. So this slide shows some of the recent works that has been done in the space of SNN training conversion. As you can see, the last three works, Sengupta, Li, and Wu, they have used several kinds of conversion or back propagation from scratch. And we have seen that for deeper architectures, we get kind of state-of-the-art accuracy, but like 1 to 2% less than the traditional ANN architecture. Sengupta et al. Showed for high number of time steps, and the main motivation of this work is to show that even for less number of time steps with appropriate conversion techniques, we can yield state of the art accuracy. Akshay, can I move on to So the conclusion states that the SNNs are energy efficient and can lead to low power neuromorphic hardware implementations. However, as we all know, direct training of SNNs with back propagation is very expensive and slow. We have explored VGG and Linet architectures for C410 and MNIST datasets respectively. We have used proper thresholding techniques to ensure that we get near lossless accuracy in SNN inference engines. And these are like 98.8% for MNIST and 91.42% for VGG. And our future works include decreasing SNN training and conversion times and scaling the proposed work to large data sets. So just before concluding this talk, I will just want to make this point that there has been huge criticism on the performance of SNN, the learning rules that are used in SNNs, and also people tell that SNNs are not able to give competitive accuracy on vision data sets, let alone other applications like robotics and recommendation systems. But the state of the art works from 2018 to 2019 suggests that we can get near lossless accuracy when we use SNNs for inference. And hence we conclude that this is the right time we can build custom hardware for these kind of SNNs. Thank you.
We would like to thank the AWS Educate program for their generous support via the cloud computing credits that they offered to us. We would also like to thank our professor, Keith Michael Chuck, for his guidance and support in performing this research project. We would extend our thanks to our mentor, Sauvik Kundu, for properly directing us and guiding us throughout the entire process. We greatly acknowledge the TAs, Oliver, Gialli, Koavan, and Arnab Sanyal for the help and guidance in several deep learning frameworks and concepts which they explained clearly to us during the entire course. Thank you so much.